kiddos, Troy Bro back with another drawing with Troy Bro. Today we're going to be looking at the artist Vincent van Gogh. He's probably one of the most famous artists around, and that's because he was very different than a lot of the other artists that came before him. He's what is known as a post-impressionist. All these artists before him usually trying to go for realism, but this guy, he tried to go for feeling. He tried to play with light and make his drawings and paintings really, really fun. I think you're going to enjoy it. Probably one of his most famous pictures is the sunflowers that he did in a nice space, a nice still life, okay? And so we're going to be basing our artwork off of these sunflowers. So get your pencils ready and let's get started.
All right, now to start my Vincent van Gogh sunflower, I'm just going to draw just one sunflower instead of drawing a bunch because this is only second grade. And drawing a sunflower can be a little difficult, but I'm gonna start with a simple shape of the circle. And then I'm gonna kind of pretend like this is a clock. So I'm gonna put a line at the top, the bottom, and then the right and the left. So it's kind of like 12 o'clock, 6 o'clock, 3 o'clock, and this would be 9 o'clock. Now, in between 12 and 3, you would have 1 and 2. So I gotta put two little lines, and you wanna make sure you're spacing them about the same space apart. And do the same thing for 4 and 5 o'clock, between 3 and 6. So I'm doing two. So it's going to be like 12 little lines in total, and this will allow me to have all of my petals be about the same size. So I'm pretending like it's a clock, starting with 12 o'clock on top, 6 at the bottom, 3 on the right, and then 9 o'clock on the left. And then I'm just going to draw little petals. From each little line, I try to give them a little bit of a curve so that they look a little more flower-like. Try not to make them just like a mountain, like not just like a triangle. I mean, if that's all you can do, then that's fine. But if you can give them a little bit of a curve, you're gonna make them look a lot more realistic. So maybe you wanna practice on a piece of scrap paper. Make sure you're drawing light. So if you do mess up, you know, you can erase your mistakes. Also feel free to pause my video or hit stop, you know, if you wanna catch up. I know I might be going too fast and you might wanna like say, hey, wait, Mr. Trowbridge. Okay, now let's come down here and draw my stem. So it's two kind of like a parallel lines that kind of curve up. Then I'm going to draw what looks like the inside of the sunflower. There's a lot of sunflower seeds, and so it looks kind of like a dandelion right in the middle. And if you look at Vincent van Gogh's sunflowers, there's all different kinds. Okay, now the fun part. I am going to color this. This is it. All right, I drew it nice and simple. So really, the fun is going to be playing with these oil pastels. Now, if you want to, you can use paint, you can use crayons, you can use color pencils, but I like oil pastels because they can kind of mix a little bit. It's really easy to mix, so if I want to get some orange and mix it with my yellow, it's going to look really pretty. All right, since I'm going to be coloring it right now and it takes me a little bit of time, probably about like 15 minutes, I'm going to speed this up so you can see what it looks like when it's all finished. I'm using yellow for the petals, brown for some of the seeds, and then a light orange right in the middle, and then blue for the sky. Before I go and start just coloring the whole sky randomly blue, what I want to do is I want to go all around my flower with the blue. That kind of gives me kind of a barrier to make sure that I don't accidentally, while I'm coloring the sky, get inside the petals. So I'm gonna go around the perimeter. That means the outline of the shape, kind of its silhouette, all right, with my blue. And then I'm also going to, after I'm done coloring all the sky blue, I think the sky's a little dark, like this blue is a little too dark. So I'm gonna take my white and go over right on top of it with an oil pastel. Now, because they're oil pastels, they blend really well. If you're using watercolor paint, you might wanna just add more water so it's a lighter blue. Or if you're using colored pencils, there's a couple different shades of blue. Make sure you're just using the lighter blue because the sky is a very light blue unless it's like, you know, a storm or it's like dark out. But I'm gonna make sure that mine is a light blue. The stem should be super easy. I'm just taking my green and coloring in that rectangle shape right there. And then I'm gonna add a couple little details to my sunflower. I'm gonna take a light orange and I'm gonna go around and add just a couple little lines, kind of like it's a sun that's radiating heat. And so I'm just adding just a little bit of orange to my yellow sunflowers and it gives it more of a 3D look. It has a little bit of value to it now. Makes it a little bit more colorful. Okay, try to always, if you can, try to mix colors a little bit. It makes it look a little more professional because you're not just using out-of-the-box colors. We don't want to just use out-of-the-box colors. We want to create some tertiary colors. That's like the colors in between the primary and the secondary. In between something like yellow and orange, you have like a yellow-orange. You can make it more yellow-orange. You can make it more orange-yellow, all right? But it just adds a little bit of more depth to your paintings. All right, as soon as I'm done adding my depth to my petals, I'm gonna take my black oil pastel and right on top of my brown, I'm gonna draw these little U's. And I wanna make sure that the U is facing the center of it. So as I'm going around, I always want to make sure that the cup of the U is always facing the middle of the flower. I'm kind of just going to go around, and these are just little sunflower seeds coming off of my sunflower. And after that, we're all done. I think the sunflower, super simple, but it's really pretty. I think the juxtaposition, that means when two things are next to each other, but we have these warm colors, this yellow and this orange and brown right in the middle, and then the cold of the blue has like this nice opposite colors that are kind of, polarizing. They're contrasting. And with that, we are all finished with our Van Gogh sunflower.
Well, kiddos, I hope you had fun drawing your sunflower. Make sure that you keep practicing and stay tuned to my channel because we're always making new stuff. And I'll see you next time on Drawing with Herbro.